Hey guys, welcome to another Abrant 3's Halo costume making tutorial. I'm going to try to cover sizing the armor pieces when it comes to accurately measuring each part of your body. I'll tell you where to measure from. I'll tell you the 2 points for each armor piece so that you can get the best possible measurement for your size. All these models that I'm about to show you are the highest definition models I could possibly find. A lot of them came from the Pepecura file index that I showed you the link in my first tutorial on Pepecura modeling, or you could also search for them at www.405th.com. The link's over in the info window to the right there. We'll cover the arm pieces first, starting with the forearm. This is what it should look like, roughly in proportion to the rest of your body. The 2 points where you'll need to measure from, and keep in mind when you're measuring, you want to measure everything by height. So it's as you stand straight up and down with your arms down to your side looking straight ahead. This is the bottom, this is the top. So the bottom of this armor piece would be the wrist area and the top would be the elbow. Measure from your wrist bones, and remember this is all in centimeters. Measure from your wrist bones to just a little bit past your elbow, a couple of centimeters. I'll go ahead and tell you that my piece was scaled, I'm about 6'3". This one was scaled 30 centimeters high. So that'll just give you a reference point. Also want you to take into consideration that when it is scaled at this size, the opening here is a little too small to fit your hand in. So what I did was I wanted it to be the right proportion, so I sized it this way, was I took the wrist guards right here and just cut slits on the side so that it gives a little bit, and you'll be able to slip your hand all the way in without it totally looking really bad or damaging it. Moving on to the shoulder piece, this is what it should roughly look like into proportion to the rest of your body. It's measured from the bottom to the top. The bottom is just measured from the very end of your bicep as your arm is extended down to your side, and then measure all the way up to the top of your shoulder, straight out perpendicular to you this way, because there is a little bit of overlap for this pouch area here. Just as a reference, my shoulder piece is sized at 32 centimeters high. Moving on to the helmet, the bottom of this measurement is going to be from the bottom of your chin to the very top of your head, straight up and down, but you don't want to measure from here to here diagonally. You start at this point and then move your ruler back or your measuring tape back to about where your ear is, and then measure straight up from there to the top of your head. You should probably start, for a reference, around 25 or 26 centimeters high for your helmet. Anything bigger than 27 will be way too big. Anything smaller than 24 will be way too small. So if your numbers are bigger or smaller than that, then you need to consider measuring again. The gloves, I'll go ahead and tell you, I have big hands. These are large size gloves, and these hand plates are sized at 2.6 centimeters high. They're measured this way, not this way or that way. So 2.6 centimeters high would be a good starting point for your hand plates. Your boot pieces, you measure basically from the bottom of your shoe that you're going to use to mount the plates to. Measure from the bottom of your shoe to probably about 2 or 3 centimeters above your ankle. I'll go ahead and tell you that this boot, I wear about a size 13 tennis shoe, and this boot was sized at 16 centimeters high, so that'll give you a good reference point. Your shin piece, this is what it should look like in proportion to your boot. There is a little bit of space here, about 2 centimeters of space between your boot and the bottom of your shin piece. You'll measure from the very top of your kneecap all the way down to probably about five or six centimeters above your ankle. You may want to finish your boot piece first. Measure about 2 centimeters from the top of your boot up to the top of your kneecap. I'll go ahead and tell you that this one was sized at 40 centimeters high. Moving on to the thigh piece, this is what it should look like in proportion to your leg. The bottom you'll need to measure from the top of your kneecap, leaving off where the shin piece stops, all the way up to where your hip bone is, where this ball and socket joint on your leg is. You'll be able to feel it right here. Not this bone way up here, but the one where your leg connects to your hip, a little anatomy lesson here. So I'll go ahead and tell you that this one was measured at 40 centimeters high as well. The waist piece, I'm still modeling this one from Pepakura. I'm not quite done with it yet. But I'll go ahead and tell you that my waist is about 30 to 32 inches around. And this one is going to fit me fine. And it is sized at 30 centimeters high. The thing with these waist pieces is that you'll actually have to cut them and install a belt around the inside to be able to get your legs around it and just wrap it around your waist and buckle it. Don't try to put your legs in it and pull it up like a pair of underwear. It's not meant to be put on that way. So for a 30 to 32 inch waist, this is going to be measured at 30 centimeters high. I'm not sure how to tell you how to size other waist sizes. My best guess is that if you're, say, a 34 to a 36 inch waist, just add an extra centimeter or two to the height. Just go every 2 inches of waist size, try to go up only 1 or 2 centimeters high. So that's my best guess for you. I haven't started on the chest and back piece yet, but I'll try to get a good measurement to you guys as soon as I can. Everything I showed you as far as the arm and the leg, it was just on the right side. But obviously, all you need to do is just copy the same measurement for the left side. I wouldn't recommend just going flat out with my reference measurements. You do need to make sure you measure each point multiple times so that it's right for you. I'm a really tall guy. I'm pretty lean, so it's not going to be right for everybody. So make sure that you measure yourself over and over again. Get the average and just go from there. So I hope this helped y'all out. We'll see you guys again soon.